Join us for a new way to talk technology, enterprise, and innovation. I'm Aksa Tariq, Editor-in-Chief, CXO Magazine.
And I'm Imran Khan, Managing Director, Rapid Compute.
And we're bringing you the podcast, Tech Drive with Aksa and Imran.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome to another episode of Tech Drive with Aksa and Imran. We have someone very special on our episode today, who's Yusuf Hussain, who's been responsible for really setting up the foundation of the startup ecosystem in Pakistan. He was previously the CEO of Ignite, which was known as the National ICT R&D Fund, where he's helped build incubators across the country, a seed fund, and an AI-powered training portal. Very interestingly, Ignite was recently acknowledged on a global platform by the United Nations, where about, I think, 1,300 projects were submitted by governments and private sector. And, Pakistan was recognized. And I think it felt great because the startup ecosystem has been in the news for many reasons. But this just gave, I think, more of a validation to all of us trying to do our little part. Currently, Yusuf Hussain heads venture capital at Habib Bank Limited, where he's focused on deals that promote digital financial inclusion and learning for HBL on its digital journey. I'd like to now hand it over to my co-host, Imran Khan, to do a quick intro, and then we probe into why and how, the work that Yusuf has been doing here. Over to you, Imran.
Thank you, Aksa. Yusuf, once again, thank you for joining us and being a part of this show. And you're an extremely popular personality in the IT scheme, and especially with your Ignite legacy and so much work that you've done for the startup ecosystem. So I'd like to start from there. So one of the most interesting things I wanted to know when I spoke to you in person finally was that, tell us a little bit about how that journey at Ignite was, because people are calling the NICs and all the work that was done over the last 3-4 years in your tenure quite a landmark achievement for the ecosystem of the country. So if you could just tell us a little bit about how it was like and what it took, and what was your goal and motivation when you were like working towards digitizing the landscape or changing the landscape or the ecosystem for Pakistani startups, and basically at the core of what ICT R&D Fund had been doing and then what Ignite, as you called it, started doing. Agar aap thoda isse bata sakein.
First of all, Imran and Aksa, thank you very much for inviting me and giving me such a great introduction. I don't know if I'm worthy of it or not. But I would say that my let's say my professional career, 23 years old, my goal is supporting the Pakistan tech ecosystem. And when we started out back in the early 90s in the United States, we used to run into Infosys and Wipro and TCS, and we used to win projects from them. Indian market was less than $100 million. We were whatever. We ourselves were more than $10 million. So, I said, you know, we used to compete. Today, they have reached $20-30 billion. So, it hurts a little bit. And one wants to promote companies which can take them on, including your company, Imran.
Did you?
Including your company, cloud-based computing. Let's say remote-based, joke software engineers provide career world-class software engineers in Silicon Valley.
Did you?
So that's been a basic motivation. Now, what happened at Ignite was serendipity, coming alignment of intentions. The minister was very supportive. The minister started this program. Anusha Rahman, she went to London. She saw Tech City. And my job was implementation. And if the minister didn't have anything, nothing would happen, quite frankly. My job was implementation. What I did within Ignite was that there were some people at assistant manager level, whatever. There were others at GM level, not producing anything. I promoted people to 3 levels. I fired people. I fired GMs. Aaj bhi unke court cases chal rahe. So, magar people who deliver, you promote them. People who don't deliver, you fire them. Simple as that.
And I like how you kept that really simple. But I'm really sort of intrigued to know, you know, this wasn't an easy feat. I think setting up something, especially at a national level, and even though incubators had already started, especially like Plan 9 and other, I think, private incubators that also came about, like I think there was Dot Zero, and then there was the Nest.io that also came about. But doing this and going to... even something like setting up an NIC in Balochistan, for example, or setting up NIC in Karachi, which I feel like maybe it was 10 years too late for a city like Karachi. If you could, sort of go over some of the milestones that you've seen, even in the IT industry at large, you know, you've also been working on a lot of like legislative work or really lobbying for the industry at large. And as you said, you know, you were passionate about technology and you were passionate about building Pakistan. But what did it really take? Yeah.
You know, we started out, we were the first kind of IT export company, Pressoft, in the early 90s. Systems was there. Today, I'm so satisfied to see that it's a $250 million market cap company on PSX. But at that time, Systems was focused on Pakistan and Pressoft started with export. And at one time, we were bigger than Systems, TechLogix, NetSol combined. But the point was that our kind of DNA was high profile, high risk projects, like a B2B e-commerce, where we were Schlumberger, we were with BPM&Co, we were with ICI, we were, these kind of chemical sector, telecom sector, Fortune 500, Global 2000 companies. We took a high-risk, high-reward approach. Now, what happened in 2000 was that dot-com burst. So it's okay. We took a high-risk, high-reward approach. We did not do these other kind of projects. And we suffered the consequences. It's fine. We went in with eyes open. And but what one sees now is that a lot of, you know, I am inspired by these new generation of entrepreneurs. Main ye bhi nahi keh raha ki ye koi American university, European university graduates hain. Ye LAMS ke honge, IBA ke honge, Chicha Vatani University ke honge. But they have a passion. They have a passion to make the world a better place. And, you know, that may be a cliche, but I've seen a lot of drive and it energizes one. Now, agar main venture capitalist ke hawale se baat karun, passion is great. You got to be open. You got to be honest. You got to discuss your mistakes, lessons learned. You can't be trying to be perfect. Magar hum ye dekhte hain ki dimag mein keeda ho. Analysis of data, you know, good analysis, how do we pivot, what did we learn? We look at that thing. And at HPL VC Fund, that's a primary thing. Now, theek hai, if somebody has done Taraz, somebody has done Kareem, yes, we respect that. But if somebody has not done those things, local graduate, but demonstrates the traits, we respect that as well. And very happy to see that our first 6 months, which 2001 investment, mainly from overseas, including Kleiner Perkins, was in the last 2 years. So people are being seen. There's a huge market here. There are people who think, there are people who innovate. And we are here to support them. Jahan tak NIC ka hawala hai, bade log tanqeed bhi karte hain ki NIC se kya nikla hai, kitni funding hui hai. Whatever. Now, the facts on the ground are okay, $6.84 of funding from the private sector for every dollar put in by NIC, Ignite. And for example, NIC Quetta, you discussed that, the team there, they traveled 2,000 kilometers, they went to many, many districts of Balochistan, jahan pe mera security situation nahi thi. Main khud gaya hun. मैंने वेमेन यूनिवर्सिटी में टॉक्स डिलीवर किए हैं इनोवेशन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप के बारे में एंड द एंड रिजल्ट इज दिस दैट इन द लास्ट कोहोर्ट और द सेकंड लास्ट कोहोर्ट वी हैव 13 वेमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स 12 मेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स देयर आर वेमेन कमिंग अप they are doing. Maslan dukhtar hai, 300 unhone khawateen hire ki hui hai. They are doing handicrafts and they're exporting to the world. Pakistan mein to kar hi rahe. So I think NIC Quetta mein, NIC Peshawar mein, there was a huge impact. And as well as in NIC Islamabad, Karachi and Lahore.
So excellent. So aapne abhi beech mein abhi HBL Ventures ki jo baat ki. So when HBL Ventures, when you know we heard about Yusuf Hussain going and starting up with HBL Ventures as leading it, it wasn't much of a surprise because everybody knew how passionate you were about jo aapne bhi khud bataya, your view on the startup ecosystem, looking at all the investment coming to neighboring countries, wanting that to come to Pakistan as well. And I think one of the first investments that HBL Ventures did was in Finja, which was you know, another very well established, very well reputed organization. So it's very important for us to understand, because HBL obviously is an older bank, and you know, amazingly it has pivoted into one of the banks that have been on the forefront of digitization now. So I mean, thoda I'm very intrigued to know ke how was that journey in order to convince HBL to do this kind of thing. And abhi bhi, now that you're involved with them, what is the kind of DNA that you're looking for? What is that kind of thing that HBL Ventures looks for when it starts evaluating startups or evaluating segments that it wants to invest into?
I think great questions, Imran. Now, first of all, when I entered the HBL, I not had a boss for like 24 years. Last time was Cresoft, which was my CEO before me, right? That was back in 97. So that in itself would have been an adjustment. And by the way, my kind of wife advised me, and that's why I joined HBL. And many people asked me, you inspire people to open, you know, to found companies, and you got a job. You know, people asked me that. They emailed me, they called me, blah, blah. Now, the thing is that I derive vicarious pleasure from founders who are inventing things. That's why I did this, first of all, the VC fund. Because, you know, you have vicarious pleasure. You're not doing it yourself, but you're doing it with five or six founders one step away. The second thing is that I think, you know, I've dealt with CXOs in the USA, I've in all these companies I mentioned, and particularly in Time Warner, I spent time with the CEO, the chairman, Ted Turner, Gerald Levine, Tom Morrow. And these guys are, in my mind, world class. And the board has made a serious decision ke VC fund karna hai. And the CEO and the CEO are completely behind it. And when we meet with startups, literally the CEO says that we are dealing as equals. Don't think we are a big bank, you're a 10-man company. We are here to learn from you. Because had we been able to do it, we would do it ourselves. So it's a very respectful relationship. It's a win-win relationship. And with Finja, you mentioned Finja, we have set up a working group which includes the CEO, who's like the co-CEO, and head of branch banking, head of lending, and maybe eight other people. We meet every 2 weeks for half an hour. We are supporting Finja in five, six different ways. And, you know, that's what fulfills one. That is not, venture capital is not just about money. It's about value add. And we are doing that, and we hope to do that with each and every company we invest in.
I mean, that's wonderful to hear. Sir, I want to have a follow-up question on this. One of the biggest criticisms I hear about emerging VC funds, not HBL ki baat nahi kar raha, main HBL mein hote hue aapki opinion le raha hu. There is a, this mushroom of local VC ventures that have come up. Many people or many startups, when they pitch to them or, you know, they come away disappointed, they say that these VC funds don't know the difference between PE investments and VC investments. And they say ki jo jis kisam ke sawal humse puche ja rahe hote hain, jis mein the returns expectation hoti hai, wo to bilkul waise hi hota hai jaise company mein aap invest karte ho aur dividend ki umeed rakhte hain. What's your view on this? Because a lot of startups that I meet at NIC and otherwise as well, because I'm very much into the ecosystem, they come away disappointed when they meet a lot of these newer VC funds. And they say, yaar, ye VC to hai nahi, na to unke sentiments VC wale hain, na unki appetite VC wale hain, ye to pehle din se return aur dividend ki baat karna shuru kar dete hain. Can you give a little bit of your view on that?
देखें इसीलिए हमने एनआईसी सेटअप किया था कि फाउंडर्स हो गए देर आर फाउंडर्स विद वेरी हाई एक्सपेक्टेशंस एंड नॉट हैविंग डन द ड्यू डिलिजेंस मेंटर्स हो गए जिनको समझ नहीं आई और इन्वेस्टर्स बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हैं इस किस्म के हैं बिल्कुल दे वांट कंट्रोल मैं मतलब दे हैव बीन वीसी फंड्स बिफोर दे वांटेड कंट्रोल सीईओ का शेयर कम कर दिया उसको मार्जिनलाइज कर दिया उसको डीमोटिवेट कर दिया उसे रिजाइन कर दिया एंड द कंपनी वेंट डाउन ठीक है ना सो दिस इज व्हाई वी सेट अप द एनआईसी टू चेंज द इकोसिस्टम एंड चेंज द थिंकिंग के यू कैन नॉट डू दिस दिस इज व्हाई जैसे मैं पहले कह रहा था कि मॉर्गन स्टैनली गोल्डमैन सैक्स इन्वेस्ट करते लेट अलोन चेस एंड सेटी You got to respect the CEO, you got to spiritually energize the CEO, and you got to think win-win rather than control and risk management. Yehi to exactly. I 100% agree.
Bilkul. Another thing, if Aksa, unless you have a question, I just have a couple of very exciting questions from Yusuf Saab. If you want to have a go, Aksa, go ahead.
Yeah. So I wanted to ask with reference to what you talked about at HPL, you know, I've always been interested in learning about how the system works and in getting more corporates on board, because that's been a challenge for our local startup ecosystem also. And I think I was talking to you about this offline as well, that, you know, there were technology companies that are, you know, trying to give back. So whether it's NetSol doing its own incubator or whether it's Systems Limited now, you know, investing in Pakistani startups. What about the corporate sector? And that's a gap that we've all seen that, you know, they're all setting up their corporate innovation centers and their innovation labs. But what is it like to bridge that gap between where the innovation is happening and the corporate sector, which is sort of like hard and bent on the way they want to run things?
Well, that is the challenge. That is the exhilarating thing. That when you find a corporate, be that Jazz, I think that Irfan Bab Khan has, set up Velocity and progressive looking. I think that Amir Ibrahim, same. I mean, he's on the board of Ignite now. And so there are some companies, Unilever, I mean, Engro, yes. We see some companies which are doing this out of, I don't know, 600 public listed companies, maybe 1%. Generally, for example, if we read Paul Romer, economist, Nobel Prize winner 2 years ago, and why did he win the Nobel Prize? It is that countries need to innovate. They need to compete. They need to think. It's not rent-seeking. You know, this is our sugar industry, real estate, textile, it's rent-seeking. Automobiles, rent-seeking. So, we got to innovate. Where we are innovating is, for example, IT exports. We are competing as the world and winning, right? We are startups, we are competing and winning. So, fundamentally, we got to become a competitive economy and we got to open it up to everyone. Koi hamari jimmedari ki ka beta ho ya koi ho, he has to receive the same education. She has to receive the same education. She, he have to compete. I mean, there's no secret about it. A.S. Moglu has written a book about it called Why Nations Fail. And it's the same concept. We got to involve everybody. We got to engage everybody. And we can't be an elitist, capturist society. Simple as that. I mean, the results are for us to see around the world. Now, with NIC, we made a little effort for that. We said, if, for example, NIC Islamabad is getting 2,500 applications and they're selecting 25, that shows that there's been some engagement with society. And we are accessing everybody, not just a elitist little, whatever, foreign graduates or blah, blah. We are accessing everybody. We got to access the mass intelligence of our people. And basically, that's it.
You know, I couldn't agree more. I think the more people you engage, I think we kind of we've grown to underestimate the quality of talent that's out there in the country. And the only way we discover it is through Facebook and Instagram, and then it's a humbling moment. Yaar, itna talent hai. Kisi ne electronic vehicle bana di, kisi ne bike bana di, kisi ne motor bana di. Solar mein kaam ho raha hai. And then we realize that most of these guys are doing a lot of innovation. But that being said, because you're in the thick of it, Yusuf Saab, mujhe bataye in terms. I mean, when and it's not a political question. It just happens to be about politics. When the new government came into existence, so at that time we were all also on the cusp of a digital revolution, and a very big part of the new government and the new plans were about digitizing Pakistan. And you've spoken a lot about it, and you've also given a lot of pointers on what needs to be done. Sitting today in 2021, almost at the end of 2021, and now looking at one of the largest VC funds or venture funds in the country, what do you think is going right, and what in your view could be the 2-3 things that you would love seeing being done in the country to take it further on its digital journey?
Okay, first of all, I support and admire Minister Sharma. You know, because in her tenure, these 5 NICs were launched, Digital.pk, 1 million or 3 million people earning whatever multiple of $100 million, and then the seed fund, including knowledge platform, Bakhabar Kisan, we funded them. So I appreciate her sincerity and competence, first of all. And, I'm quite frankly a PTI supporter. And, maslan, inhone jo SDCA ordinance leke aaye hain, Special Technology Zones Authority, I think it's a massive step. And I think this could turn the country around, because we saw the same thing in India and Philippines. And all these tax breaks is what's needed. So I think it's a huge thing. Number two, I think Shaukat Rehn saab ki jo meeting hui hai with the PASHA chairman and PCB MD and Secretary IT, and this 1% withholding tax on IT export, which, you know, opens you up to, let's say, harassment. Inhone jo iski wapas se lene ki baat ki hai. I think that's big. We've crossed $2 billion. We may cross $3.5 billion, $3.9 billion, when I figure sunne next year in IT exports. And I think, agar ye zara ease of doing business ho jaye, और ये हरेसमेंट बंद हो, जाहिर है हमने टैक्स सारे पूरे देने, दैट्स आवर मॉरल एंड एथिकल रिस्पांसिबिलिटी, वो हमने देने हैं, मगर वी शुड नॉट बी ओपनिंग आवरसेल्व्स अप टू हरेसमेंट एंड ह्यूमन कांटेक्ट. इट शुड बी डिजिटल बेस्ड गवर्नेंस, जैसे मिनिस्टर ने कहा, पीओएस बेस्ड पॉइंट ऑफ सेल, नॉट डायरेक्टली टू विद आईटी कंपनीज, मैं जनरली बात कर रहा हूँ, पीओएस बेस्ड टैक्सेशन. And, इसी तरह एक्सपोर्ट में जो हम करेंगे, सो वी हैव टू पे आवर टैक्सेस, बिल्कुल ठीक है, बट वी गॉट टू रिड्यूस मैन्युअल इंटरेक्शन सो दैट वी रिड्यूस एनी एवेन्यूज फॉर हैरेसमेंट. तो ये मेरे ख्याल में बिल्कुल ठीक है, और मेरे ख्याल में कंस्ट्रेंट जो है, अगर हम देखें, फिर मैं नेबर की एग्जाम्पल दूंगा कि Bangalore has more engineering colleges than any city in the world. Right now, it's a supply side issue for Pakistan. It's a supply side issue in terms of people who can program, people who are graduating, can't write a line of code, let alone ke hum phir aage baat kare cyber security ki, ya crypto ki, ya data science ki, ya risk design, वो तो आगे की बात. They can't even code. So we have to devise a program where they code and they can deliver value. तो खास तौर पे मेरा focus इस किस्म की कंपनियों पे है, not because of HBL VC fund by the way, but in the national interest कि हमने अपने programming world class program resources develop करने. जहाँ तक HBL VC fund का ताल्लुक है, we are here to to help HBL in learning in its digital journey, so it still remains relevant 5-10 years down the line when these paradigm shifts happen. We are here for digital financial inclusion. Farmers ho gaye, tourists, operators ho gaye, jo bhi unbanked hain, hum unko include karna chahte hain. I feel there's a lot of value to credit for businesses, not necessarily for consumption, but for businesses to expand the business. And there are many use cases. Farmers le le, kariana stores le le, aap finjago le le. Inke kariana stores ka profit and everything has expanded a great deal because of these kind of credit. So this is the way we build our economy. This is the way we build our society. So that's what we're interested in.
What does it get right this time around compared to, you know, what happened 2 decades ago? And especially because in your intro, you mentioned a couple of things back from like the early 2000s, when there was like a first round of internet startups in Pakistan, where companies like TMT Ventures, you know, they had actively invested in so many tech startups. A lot of them did not end up surviving. So what do we have, going right for us this time around? And how would you, of course, make a dent in that?
Well, first of all, there are some trends and there are some lessons learned. आपने TMT Ventures की बात की है, तो देखिए ना, वहाँ पे उन्होंने more of a traditional business view लिया, accounting view लिया, founders, CEOs के shares कम हो गए, they were not interested anymore. So number one lesson learned is we got to understand venture capital better. The key kind of force is not the money in the bank, it's the energy of the CEO. Theek hai na, man or woman, whatever. So, aap udhar hi unko go kar denge, minoritize or whatever, then what's going to happen? Theek hai na? So, to me, this gut feelings matter a lot. People look at numbers and everything, but everybody should be thinking win-win, first of all. That's the first thing. And that's a lesson we learn here. Achha, jahan tak 20 saal pehle abhi ki baat hai, humare mulk mein 20 saal pehle bhi bada kuch ho sakta tha. It's just that we got into the civil war and some other distractions. Else, we would be like many other countries, be that Indonesia, Bangladesh, Nigeria. And we could have done a lot 20 years ago as well. Aisi baat nahi hai. It was just, in my opinion, a security situation. It's solved now. And the world is looking. It's a huge market. We got some super talented, mashallah, people. And, we got to energize them.
Achha, isme one of the things, Yusuf Saab, I want to know your view on. Abhi aapne jab pichle baat kar rahe the, to aap bata rahe the about a supply issue in Pakistan. I couldn't agree more. I've spent countless hours and years on this and trying to get universities and education institutes to understand the importance of filling the supply gap, because abhi a situation aisi ho gayi hai ki the companies like ours that are contributing to that 2 billion and hopefully the 3.9 billion in exports, they're headcount thirsty right now. They need more developers, they need more UI UX designers, they need more AI ML coders, they need everybody in all these disciplines. And there is such a dearth of these individuals in the country कि जितने भी बड़े इदारे हैं उनको मजबूरन अपनी यूनिवर्सिटीज अपनी स्कूलें खोलनी पड़ गई हैं. 10 Pulse की मिसाल ले लें, आप सिस्टम की मिसाल ले लें, हमारा अपना ट्रेनिंग सेंटर और कोचिंग सेंटर है जहां हम लोग ट्रेन करते हैं. इट्स बिकॉज देर इज प्रैक्टिकली नो सप्लाई कमिंग इन फ्रॉम द मार्केट एंड देयर हैव बीन मल्टीपल फोरम जहां पर यू डिस्कस भी हुआ है HEC के साथ, इंडिविजुअल यूनिवर्सिटीज के साथ, बट दे टेंड टू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द डेप्थ एट विच दिस इज अ नीड. And also the it's a crisis. It's just like an energy crisis. It's a crisis. क्योंकि हम मुल्क को डिजिटाइजेशन की तरफ लेके जा ही नहीं सकते जब आपके पास टूल्स और वो हेडकाउंट अवेलेबल नहीं है उस मशीनरी को पावर करने के लिए. एंड मैंने तो कम अज कम 5-6 साल से देखा है कि इस पर बहुत कम हेडवे हुआ है. व्हाट्स योर व्यू ऑन दिस एंड व्हाई डोंट पीपल ट्रीट दिस एज अ क्राइसिस? इट इज अ क्राइसिस. आप अपना व्यू बताएं कि क्यों नहीं हो रहा और क्या किया जा सकता है इस पर अर्जेंटली, बिकॉज जिससे भी आप बात करें, चाहे वो TPS हो, चाहे वो सॉफ्टवेयर सिस्टम हो, नेट सोल, कोई भी हो, दे वाइड आउटसोर्स अब्रॉड और they're training their own people, which is time consuming and cost intensive. So, इस पे आप ही क्या राय है?
मेरी राय ये है, कि जो लोग इसको क्राइसिस नहीं समझते वो हालात को नहीं समझते हैं और मुस्तकबिल को नहीं समझते हैं एंड दे डोंट डिजर्व टू बी आवर लीडर्स सिंपल एज दैट जाहिर है ये क्राइसिस है और मेरा मतलब है यही तो की प्रॉब्लम जो हमें टैकल करना है मैंने पहले भी बोला है कि एचआर वर्ल्ड क्लास प्रोग्रामर्स ये हमारी किल्लत है हमने digiskills.pk किया था एट अ लोअर लेवल मिडिल लेवल टेक्नोलॉजी स्किल्स जो कि बड़ा जरा मुबादला कमा रहे हैं दुनिया से और हमारा दूसरा प्रोग्राम था codyskills.pk बाय द वे codyskills.pk वाज फॉर 10,000 प्रोग्रामर्स वर्ल्ड क्लास ओके सो मतलब व्हाट आर यू टेलिंग मी आई मीन आई अंडरस्टैंड मतलब आई नो द प्रॉब्लम अगर वो मेरा टेनर खत्म हो गया हुआ नहीं बट एनीवे आई हैव सेंट इट टू रिमोट बेस्ड एक ये जो सैन फ्रांसिस्को बेस्ड है कासिम असद इज यू नो इज प्रोवाइडिंग वर्ल्ड क्लास प्रोग्रामर्स टू सिलिकॉन वैली मैंने उसे ये किया कि यार हमें भी वर्ल्ड क्लास प्रोग्रामर्स प्रोवाइड करना हमें भी जरूरत है एचबीएल में हमें जरूरत है मगर की प्रॉब्लम यही है कि इट्स अ सप्लाई चेन यू डोंट हैव क्वालिटी पीपल ठीक है ना So, you do something, you do whatever you want, but do something like codyskills.pk. 4-5 months of programming, you know and learn to program, you understand data structures, you know search algorithms, blah, blah. And then you do 4-5 months of whatever. I mean, joe.ns, data science, cybersecurity, crypto, risk. chip design, whatever. ठीक है ना तीन चार महीने बेसिक प्रोग्रामिंग करें तीन चार महीने आप स्किल्स इन डिमांड करें हमने पूरा प्रोग्राम बनाया था और मेरे ख्याल में इसके अलावा कोई चीज है नहीं इतना टाइम लगेगा आपको ट्रेन होने के लिए आपको लगेंगे 6-9 महीने आप ग्रेजुएशन रेट को 20% हो ठीक है ना वी कांट एक्सपेक्ट मोर देन दैट And but we'll produce 4-5 thousand world-class programmers starting off, and then more as we expand the program. Open source bada lazmi hai. Aap open source ke projects pe jaye, aap programming kare, aap naye dekhen dekhte hain kitne log aapke aapke jo bhi programming hai wo accept karte hain. There are known ways to do this. I mean, I don't think it's rocket science.
I think we've seen that with the, especially with the DigiSkills program, and I think it's still running. Mujhe yaad hai jab aapko relaunch kare the a few years ago, and it's taken. I think you guys have also taken it to a lot of cities across Pakistan. I think during the pandemic, a lot of students who had extra time on their hands, a lot of youngsters who were either out of jobs or you know were looking to make some extra bucks on the side, they were really like sort of you know working on upskilling. Their own, I think, knowledge. So I think you're right that, you know, and unless, of course, you know, it's on a national platform, there's no way that, or a national level at least, there's no way that this supply issue is not going away anytime soon. But I think, as Imran also rightly pointed out, you know, a lot of technology companies, you said HPL needs it, people like us in the tech media, we need it, people like Imran, you know, who've been working or and have everything sort of built in-house. So I think resource management, yeah, resource skill development, I think is a big area for any one of us that I think we struggle with. Imran, if you'd like to, I have one last question, but I'm going to keep that for the end. If you'd like to chime in here.
Yeah. So thanks. So I had, few people, startups I knew I was going to interview Yusuf Saab. So they had a few questions and I'd like to ask on their behalf. So in your shoes as an HBL Ventures, right? And we have a lot of aspiring startups. Some of them are quite senior in the industry. उन्होंने काफी डेट पे जाके अपने काम शुरू किए हैं. कुछ लोग बहुत यंग हैं. And one of the key things that I usually they ask for advice on is when a venture fund like HBL, looks at startups. What are those key 2-3 X factors that you look for? Both in the model as well as the people itself who come to you, like the founders and the people. What are those 2-3 key X factors that kind of give you that hunch on that feel, yeah, these are people that we would like to take a punt on?
जी इमरान, तो जैसे मैंने पहले थोड़ा सा इस पे टच किया था कि वन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हेन वी आर लुकिंग अर्ली स्टेज कंपनीज देयर इज नो इन्वेंटरी देयर इज नो श्योरिटी गारंटी रिसीवेबल्स मेन थिंग इज द कैरेक्टर ऑफ द फाउंडर नाउ फाउंडर में पहली चीज होनी चाहिए जाहिर है पैशन एंड ओपननेस अगर आप खोल के बात नहीं कर सकते हैं तो आगे क्या बात करेंगे बी ओपन दिमाग कीड़े की तरह होना चाहिए थिंक थ्रू थिंग्स हैव द आंसर्स कुछ चीजें हमें नहीं पता कुछ चीजें हमें पता है ये हमारा एनालिसिस है ये मेरी थिंकिंग है कोई लॉजिक हो ठीक है ना और जाहिर है तो ये मेरे जाविये से ये फंडामेंटल चीजें हैं जस्ट बी ओपन एंड जस्ट शो योर थिंकिंग आई मीन If you're asking for funding, let's see ke you've thought things through. Uske alawa, theek hai. Log dekhte hain ki Dras ka background hai ya Kareem ka background.
Kareem wagera ha.
Ye theek hai na? Ya koi Harvard ka McKinsey ka hai, theek hai. Wo dekh lenge. Magar mere liye wo cheez important nahi. Just be open. Just show you can defend your perspective. That's the first thing. Now. करंट जो हमारा इन्वेस्टमेंट थीसिस एचपीएल में है वी आर बिट रिस्क अवर्स कल को हम चेंज प्रॉब्ली करेंगे मगर शुरू कर रहे थे तो थोड़ा सा रिस्क अवर्स होना था कि इट इज आफ्टर द फर्स्ट राउंड ऑफ फंडिंग इज विद द को-इन्वेस्टर ठीक है ना ये हमारा इस वक्त है कल को शायद चेंज हो जाए वी मे बिकम मोर रिस्की द सीईओ एक्चुअली वांट्स अस टू बी
Immediately for this, like, are there any particular industry verticals that you know? Because, you know, I think we've seen in the last 1 year or 1.5 year, some investment bahar se bhi aayi hai. A lot of people are either interested in fintech or health or education. Is there any particular sort of industry vertical that's been on your radar or the same for HPL Ventures at large?
No, excellent question. Excellent question. So, I would relate it back to ke HPL ne VC fund kyun kaim kiya? Ke help HPL learn along its digital journey. Banking is changing. Like Brad King for Roto says, banking everywhere except at a bank. It's online, it's on your education platform, it's your healthcare platform, it's blah, blah, wherever. So, pehla maksad ye hai ke masan kariana stores, unbanked sector, maybe whatever, 1 to 2 million stores in Pakistan. We don't have rich data, we don't know exactly. But it's a huge market. Finjas is lending to them. So here we have an opportunity for all sorts of things. We have opportunities for lending. We have opportunities to support their salary demand card in ATM machines. We have opportunities ke hamare 50,000 connect ke agents hain. Udhar ye cash wapas kare apne lending ka. Kyunki Kariana stores lending agar le Finjas se पैसे तो उनको लोग कैश में देते हैं अनफॉर्चुनेटली अभी भी वी वुड लाइक टू डिजिटाइज एवरीथिंग दे कैन कम टू 50,000 केसेस एंड डिपॉजिट दे कैन यूज द फिंजा मोबाइल कार्ड टू कैश आउट एज वेल सो दिस इज हाउ वी ट्राई टू सपोर्ट बियॉन्ड द मनी के वी से मनी में टेक यू टू 30% मंथ ऑन मंथ ग्रोथ वी विल डू ऑल दीज अदर थिंग्स टेक यू 60% मंथ ऑन मंथ ग्रोथ सो इंस्टेड ऑफ If raising four times in valuation, raise 10 times. That's our time. That's our thinking. We are thinking win-win. ठीक है ना? We don't have any constraint thinking कि हमें इतना करना है तो ये equity से control करो, special rules से control करो. 51, like Aksa, you were saying about traditional investors in Pakistan. We don't have that mindset. We don't have a mentality. हमारे CEO ने बोला है, which is why I joined HPL. He's saying, ke yaar, if we knew how to do this, we would have done it ourselves. We are here to learn from them. Theek hai na? So we are here to add value and we are here to win-win.
I think that's right. We've also seen that, you know, and there are literally just a couple of banks that have been on the forefront when it comes to digitization, when it comes to allowing a space for corporate innovation also. And now I think setting up HPL Ventures has also given a good example. We've now seen different banks do these hackathons, and they're trying to get in on the game, I think. But I do feel like this industry at large has a long way to go when it comes to, banks putting in where their money, putting in the money there. One thing that I'm really interested in on a very personal level also is that, when venture ideas fail, in your experience, what seems to be like the common weaknesses that we've seen from a very Pakistani local perspective?
हमने कंपनी कितनी देखी हैं जिन्होंने स्केल की, देखे ना, to learn, we have to see companies that scale and companies which did not scale, ठीक है ना? So, for example, companies with scale, we know well, Raz, Baikia, blah, blah, blah. Baikia, by the way, NIC Karachi. Sabzi.pk raised a lot of funds, agri supply chain, folded. What lesson do we learn? The lesson that we learn is unit economics. The lesson that we learn is, like I'm saying, फाउंडर कीड़ा होना चाहिए, कीड़े से मुराद है रेज द हुड, चेक द नंबर्स, व्हाट आर द यूनिट इकोनॉमिक्स, विल दिस कंपनी रियली सर्वाइव एंड थ्राइव व्हेन वी पुट मनी इनटू इट, और इज इट शो बॉल्स, शो बिजनेस. सो या वी डू अ लॉट ऑफ ड्यू डिलिजेंस. फॉर एग्जांपल इन एचबीएल every deal I send it to legal, I send it to compliance, which is compliance with SVP, I send it to finance, I send it to audit, I send it to investment banking group. For example, abhi ek health ki deal dekh rahe hain, I send it to a person who's in HBL but on the board of Aga Khan Medical University. I send it to lending. It's open, right? It's the American approach. Be open. Put everything on the table. And let everybody share their feedback. So I think it's a very secure, it's a good environment. It's the right environment.
That's excellent to know. Wonderful to know. Aksa, you have your question? The last question you wanted to ask?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, good. So as we're nearing the end of our session, I just wanted to ask one or two important questions. One was that if you look at the startup space today, and a lot of people have a lot of ideas ki ye bhi karna hai, ye bhi karna hai, ye bhi karna hai, lekin ab main HBL ke wale se baat nahi kar raha, main ab zati aapki baat kar raha hu Yusuf Hussain ke liye. What are the one or two key areas that interest you the most and you would like to see startups working in that area? Apni personal preference kya, mujhe is category ke segment ke kaam ya startups bahut excite karte.
देखें, अगर आप पर्सनली मुझसे पूछें इमरान, तो आपको पता है जब मैं सीईओ इग्नाइट था, यूनिडो रिकॉग्नाइज्ड अस एज फोर्थ इंडस्ट्रियल रिवोल्यूशन लीडर्स. सो डीप टेक, एआई, ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी, ब्लॉकचेन, क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग लाइक यू आर डूइंग, दैट डीपली एक्साइट्स मी. आई मीन माय एक्साइटमेंट इज डीप टेक. आई एम एन इंजीनियर बाय ट्रेनिंग, I went to Cornell, Rice, so on. So, मेरे लिए तो ये exciting areas हैं. जहाँ तक के HBL VC fund का ताल्लुक है, I think we are looking at any areas which fulfill our investment thesis, which is के digital learning for HBL and ROI. So I think it's a wide area. I think it's augmented reality, artificial intelligence, blockchain, crypto, everything is included in this. And at least my goal is, and I have no reason to think board or senior management deposits, but my goal is to have a wide portfolio and have some of these kind of deep tech companies as well. And baki tumhara fintech hai, agriculture hai, tourism hai.
Yeah, so just to wrap up, Yusuf Sahab, very quickly, if you could give us some idea, as Imran also said, there are a lot of startups that do often come to us. If you were to tell like a budding entrepreneur, you know, looking for feedback on his or her business, aapne bhi pehle mujhe I picked on one thing that you said that, you know, there are a lot of mentors available out there. There are a lot of now, so to say, venture capitalists or angel investors available. But, you know, there are a lot of startups or a lot of people, youngsters, just jumping on the boat because they think it's like the next cool thing to do, do your own thing. Where do you see them or where would you want them to go for like, you know, real advice or like what should they be really looking at in the first few years of them starting a business? You know, not everyone is, of course, as you said, ready for investment. They're not ready to jump into the ecosystem as it is. What would you be your go-to advice?
First of all, I would say that entrepreneurship is tough. So don't do it for glamour. Don't think this is an easy path. It's a challenge. Vegan. But once you've decided that you don't want to do a job, you want to take this risk, which can end up in anything, if you're that tough enough, then maslan janara ka catalyst hai Karachi mein. Usme bhi Habib Bank ne invest kiya hai, Plan 9 hai, Plan X hai, Punjab IT Board mein, aur Islamabad mein bhi is tarah ke Faisal Adnan runs one. Aur phir NIC hai, NIC hai. To zahir hai, mera bias NIC ki taraf hoga. NIC mein humara focus hai on scale and transforming society. Rather than focusing necessarily on individual startups like a Y Combinator or blah blah. But mere khayal mein ye hai. Magar we've seen from the USA, we've seen from China, we've seen from India, and we've seen from Pakistan. Ke jo top startups hai, they may feel we do not need an incubator. We do it ourselves. It's okay. It's a Gaussian curve. On one end of the Gaussian curve, there are top startups that no startup can add value to. We incubators are targeting the bell curve, the middle of the Gaussian curve. And then there are others at the other end of the Gaussian curve, the bell curve, which, you know, no incubator can help approve. Magar generally main bolunga apply to incubate NIC ho jaye ya baki ho jaye, but if not, go ahead. If you think you can do it on your own, do it on your own. That's fine.
Yusuf Saab, anything that you'd like to say to anybody, youngsters out there, or anybody else, any piece of advice?
Anil, thank you so much. Great talking to both of you. Bas, yehi hai ke it's a tough business. But if you want to innovate, you want to add value, it's a tough path, but it's very fulfilling. It's very gratifying. It fulfills you as a person.
Definitely, definitely. And Yusuf Saab, thank you so much for taking out the time from your schedule to be with me and Aksa.
And I think we should discuss about cloud computing and what you're thinking about the future. Because this is, in my mind, this is a billion-dollar company that you're setting up. If you think right and you plan right, this is a billion-dollar company you're setting up.
Inshallah, bilkul, which is why I'd love to sit with you because I think you'll be very excited to know a lot of things that are being done locally. And
well, let's do that. This is what excites me, seriously.
Bilkul.
This is Bikiri's pleasure.
So that, ladies and gentlemen, was Mr. Yusuf Hussain, who's been leading the way for innovation and investment first in the public sector with his work at Ignite and now with corporates and financial institutions in his capacity as head of venture capital at HPL. This is Aksa Tariq and Imran Khan signing off. Until next time, Allah Hafiz.